Hello, everyone. Subscribe to Wear Notice. Oh, yeah. Hey, Wear Noticers, Shane here, and welcome to another video on the Wear Notice Technology YouTube channel. If you're new here, definitely take a moment to consider subscribing so you don't miss out on all my other awesome technology videos about things like smartphones, smartwatches, tech accessories, computers, tablets, cases, and really just so much more. But anyway, folks, in this video, we're going to be unboxing this guy right here. This is the Logitech MX Keys Mini Keyboard for both Mac and Windows, but I'm going to be using it with my M1 Pro 16-inch 2021 MacBook Pro, a total beast of a computer. So anyway, without further ado, let's get to getting this guy out of the box. Here we go. So folks, here we are up close and personal with this box. As you can see, it says MX Keys Mini, the Master Series by Logitech. And yes, I also do have the MX Master 3 for Mac right here. I love this mouse. It is super cool. And also here it says, minimalist wireless illuminated keyboard, Logitech, and we've got a picture of the keyboard itself. It is in that beautiful space gray and black color, which should look great with my MacBook Pro. Over here it says ultra fluid typing, and it says graphite right there. I guess they don't call it space gray, but still, you know what I mean. Over here on the back, it says it is compatible with Windows, macOS, iPadOS, iOS, Linux, Chrome OS, and Android. That is a lot of operating systems, folks, but that's definitely good. And it also says smart illumination right there. But anyway, I just want to get this guy out of the box, so I'm going to start doing just that. And let's see, it says we could turn it on and then connect with Bluetooth. And it says it's got easy switch, so you can switch between three different devices just with the click of a button. Anyway, let's grab the keyboard itself right here. Let's move the box to the side a bit. And here it is. Let's just take this tissue paper off of the keyboard so we can actually see it. And right here it says create the ultimate setup. I already got that MX Master 3 once again, so I already have the ultimate setup. Do not worry, guys. And then over here we've got the keyboard itself. So, wow, this looks very, very nice. It's got some weight to it too. Over here in this little box within a box, it talks about the setup for this keyboard and what's in here. Ooh, is that a cable? Yes, so it's got a USB-A to USB-C cable. Kind of wish this was USB-C to USB-C, but it's okay, is what it is. And let's see, do we have anything else in the box? Just some paperwork in here? Nope, let's just put this to the side and get this keyboard connected to my MacBook Pro. So now I have my 16-inch 2021 M1 Pro MacBook Pro right here, and we can just go ahead and turn the MX Keys Mini on just like that, and we see this green light flash, and now it is ready to pair. Also right here is that USB-C port if you're wondering for charging purposes, so let's pair it. And now folks, I have this keyboard connected to my Mac, and close enough, okay, fix that word, and boom. Yes, so as you can tell, this keyboard right here, the MX Keys Mini, is all connected to my Mac, so let's have some fun typing with it. Okay, we can take the MX Master 3 and move that, and what should I type? Hello, everyone, subscribe to Wear Notice. Oh yeah, very awesome. So first impression, let's see. So one of the things I'm noticing is the keycaps actually have a circular indent on all of them, if you guys can pick that up, which is different than on the MacBook Pro's keyboard where they're all flat. Another thing I'm noticing too is, yes, that is a very loud sounding keyboard versus a quieter MacBook Pro keyboard. So that's interesting right there. I'm also really seeing the backlight over here on the MX Keys Mini. And this is kind of cool. Did you notice when my hands went near the MX Keys Mini, the backlight came on? So see, now it is off. And then boom, bring my hands near it. And that's cool. It goes right on. So that's very cool. That's something the MacBook Pro over here just can't do. And yeah, another thing I'm noticing too is because I didn't get the 4 Mac version of the MX Keys Mini, because the 4 Mac version only comes in this white color and I wanted the graphite to match my computer. This version of the Keys Mini does have these split keys down here. So a command and alt key, alt if you have Windows, and also an option and start key if, once again, you have Windows. And these are kind of flopped because, as you can see on the Mac keyboard, the function key is here on the left, and then the control key is on the right, whereas on the MX Keys Mini, the control key is on the left, and the function key is on the right. So those kind of switch spots right there. But besides that, these are pretty similar keyboards, although, of course, right here, you do have those 1, 2, 3 Bluetooth switch buttons if you want to quickly switch between different devices connected to this keyboard. Like, for example, you could have your iPad on this one and maybe your phone on this one, whereas on the first one, that's the one I connected my Mac to. Also, another thing, obviously on the MX Keys Mini, you don't have a fingerprint scanner, which definitely stinks because I do like the Touch ID right here already built into the Mac, but I mean, it would have to be an Apple keyboard to be able to have the Touch ID, and it is not, it is Logitech. Besides that, yes, you can control the volume right here. That works just fine. You can mute and unmute right there. You can pause and play. But anyway, what does this button right here do? Ooh, emojis, that is pretty cool. Whereas on the MacBook Pro keyboard, if you want emojis, you press this button right here. So again, slight differences. Right here, you can go ahead and change the backlighting on the keyboard so we can make it maximum brightness right there if we really want it nice and bright. Another thing too I'm noticing about the MX Keys Mini is it is not lying flat on the table. It is at an angle because of that protruding area right here. And again, it definitely has a weight to it that makes it at an angle when you go ahead and type. So I wonder if in the long term, will this be more or less comfortable to type on? And I will say this definitely has a different feel than the standard MacBook Pro right here. So let me practice typing a bit on this. I am typing, and one thing I definitely notice is the key travel on the MacBook Pro right here on its own built-in keyboard is much less than on the MX Keys Mini because the buttons, they move down much more. So move down, silly button. Yeah, the key travel is more on the MX Keys Mini for sure. So it does feel different than typing on your MacBook Pro's keyboard. So if you want an external keyboard that feels like that, this might not be for you. And I mean, yeah, folks, with that, there's not really much more to say about the Logitech MX Keys Mini right here. If you guys want it for yourself, it'll set you back about $100. So, I mean, definitely let me know down in the comments what you guys think of this keyboard. Do you love it? Do you hate it? Do you have it for yourself? Because yes, I do read all the comments, by the way. And for me personally, I kind of just want Apple to come out with a new version of their own Magic Keyboard for the Mac that has Touch ID built in, except in this black slash space gray color to match my computer, and also with backlighting. I think that would be the ultimate perfect keyboard for me. Apple, if you're watching, just come out with that keyboard. Just do it. I don't want a white Magic Keyboard. I want a black one to match my computer. But yeah. Anyway, with that, folks, if you enjoyed this video, definitely be sure to smash that subscribe button and subscribe to the Wear Notice Technology YouTube channel for more awesome technology videos just like this one. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching, and thank you so much for subscribing. Bye.